see how they do once the game begins, but first, the toss of the coin.
Tails. We'll see.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Mare kicks it, and we are underway. Allen downs this in the end zone for a touchback.
Let's go, Miami.
The Jaguars get their offense on the field and will start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Taylor picks up about two, and that brings up second down.
Fred Taylor had some blocking help on that last one, but he was still left with nowhere to go.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more. And bunch of receivers out there. The bunch is expecting that, and they go to nickel.
Leftwich unloads this to the right sideline, and it falls incomplete.
Patrick Surtain had superb coverage on that play. No wonder it was incomplete.
On second down, they try for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
Third down, empty backfield. Smith makes the catch on the right sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
Jimmy Smith goes one-on-one on this play and beats his man. He executed that pass pattern perfectly and made the catch. Nice reception. Nope, they could not cover him man-to-man. He was one step ahead of the defense.
What a big play on third down, Peter. His run after the catch is what made the play work.
Yeah, Dan, you have to fight for those yards in that situation, and that's exactly what he did.
Smith goes in motion. Leftwich launches it out left side, and the completion is good for six.
Jimmy Smith had two guys on him on that play, but still managed to make the catch.
They move the ball, and it will be second down. Chews up 4 yards, and that brings up third down.
Arturo Freeman just planted the ball carrier in the turf short of the markers. But the only thing that's going to grow there is the D's morale.
They don't allow them to convert, but they did allow them to get very close.
Very short. Let's see if they can come up with another big stand.
Taylor gets the call again and lowers his shoulder for the first.
Fred Taylor just slammed through the D on that play for a few extra yards. Hey, that's what I call a charge.
A nice play, and with only a short distance to the first, they put it together and make it happen.
Yeah, third and short always looks easy, but it's not, Dan. It's good execution. Look at those stats. That's the definition of a standout year.
Smith catches it left sideline and is well past the markers for a first down.
Watch the pass! Here it comes! Watch the throw! Watch the throw!
Williams goes in motion. Taylor will take the handoff and only gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Adewale Ogunle not only cleaned the ball carrier's clock in the backfield, but buffed and polished it too. Big hit for a loss.
Peter, once he closes his grip around you, you are not going to get free, regardless of how evasive you are.
Not with that strength. With those guns, he could probably juggle bowling balls, or wide receivers for that matter.
Madison hammers the receiver and forces him to drop the ball. Incomplete.
Byron Leftwich threw that ball to a receiver who had two guys on him. He's probably fortunate it was just an incomplete pass at that point.
That would have gotten the first, but it's incomplete, and it will be third down.
Well, Dan, we got an empty backfield, five receivers, and the defense is in their dime. Let's watch.
Leftwich throws a heater, and they get the first on third and long.
Jimmy Smith faces down two defenders and comes away with the football. Oh, nice catch.
Fantastic catch, and he is putting up great numbers.
Got that right, Dan. He's now got 51 yards on four catches.
Wilford goes in motion. Carries this one to the right and picks up a couple. Second down, 7 yards to go. Taylor has his number called on second down, and he takes it upfield. Stopped at the 11. First down.
Nice gain on this baby. Look at him eat up the yardage here.
Nice second down call, and they will move the chains.
On offense, it was always a plus to avoid third down altogether, just like
watch
that.
Counter, watch the counter. Here comes the counter.
Madison puts a lick on the receiver and separates him from the ball. Incomplete.
Sam Madison had superb coverage on that play. No wonder it was incomplete.
That would have been a touchdown, but instead the defense comes up big and forced the incompletion.
Way to prevent the big play.
It'll be second down. Leftwich pushes it out left side, and the ball is caught for a gain of 7 on the play.
Right there.
Leftwich uses his size to his advantage. 6'5", 245, big numbers. Who needs an O-line when your QB is the size of a defender?
Come on, third down, coming up on the 15th play of the drive.
Big play coming up. Strong runner in the backfield and a great receiver on the line.
The sack at the 7. It'll be fourth down.
The Dolphins just overpower the O-line on this one. They send 5 guys in to get him, and they got him all right. Check it out. Oh, yeah, that's a great sack. The offense was powerless.
They came up big, caused the loss of yards, and more important, forced the fourth down. What a play by this team.
You said it, Dano. They're all fired up down there.
They take the lead.
Josh Stobie puts in an easy short one. A clean kick, no worries.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Scobie kicks this one away. Wilkins catches it back at the 3. The 26.
I'm bringing it all day.
Terrence Wilkins received that nice kick and a nice little run back after the catch. Good job.
Counter, counter, counter. Watch
the
counter.
Dolphins send their offense out on the field and will start this drive at their own 26-yard line. Williams picks up 6 on the play, and that will bring up second down.
David Boston made a very, very nice block back there downfield. I love to see a wide receiver getting involved like that.
They move the ball, and it will be second down.
Here comes the run. Here comes the run. The tide empty. The tide
down.
Empty.
Set.
Liz.
Grant tackles tackles him behind the line of scrimmage.
Deion Grant targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
They don't let that play get back to the line of scrimmage, and that will bring up third down. And that'll do it for quarter number one. The Jaguars with a small lead, 3-0.
Three more quarters. Let's do this, D. Double tight.
Feely throws a beauty to the right side, and it's tipped. Incomplete. Woo! That will bring up fourth down.
Jerron Bolden got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
It seemed like the defense read that one from the beginning, and they forced the incompletion with Rubble DeVee.
Beautiful call by the D coordinator.
It'll be fourth down. Turk lines up to punt after the three and out. Turk gets the snap and punts it away. Allen gets it at the 33. Brought down at the 37.
David Allen got swarmed by the kicking team before he got very far. That nice punt pretty much goes unanswered.
The Jaguars have been locked in a defensive struggle so far. They will start this drive at their 37-yard line. Leftwich fires this one over the middle, and they can't connect. Incomplete.
Byron Leftwich knows how to spread the ball around, as you can see by this passing chart here. He's getting the ball into his receiver's hands and has piled up 58 yards and no touchdowns.
Hey, watch Gunner! Watch Gunner! Ow! Gunner!
Brady catches this one and has some room to run. 10, and he's in for the touchdown.
Kyle Brady makes the catch and then takes it for a great run here. Now he's got it. If you give him the room, he'll be happy to take it from you.
A nice run after making the grab, and that's a big plus coming from your tight end.
Especially for him. He's not known for making those big gallops like that.
Now the extra point, and it's good.
Yeah, give me some, yeah, baby. Give me some. Nice job, baby. You're going all the way. Wait a minute, right here. Look,
the ref gets the signal, and we're set. Scobie kicks it off. Wilkins fields the kickoff at the 7. Tackled at the 27.
Terrence Wilkins got waylaid by the defense before he was able to put Munch on the run back.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. No, huh? Don't touch.
The Dolphins' offense has to score here. This drive will start at their own 27-yard line. Throws this and it's caught at the 32, tackled at the 36.
A.J. Feely had no trouble zinging that one past the secondary. That was one heck of a throw.
Peter, what a nice pickup to get them into a second and short situation.
Yeah, great play, and now they have a bunch of options on what to try next.
Second down and less than four. Takes the handoff and picks up the first down.
Check that out. Those last year numbers are solid.
Feely pushes it on the left side, and it's good for a gain of 8.
Chris Chambers had a defender close by but was able to bring down the catch.
That'll be his first catch of the game after being shut out the entire first quarter. This is a bit of a slow start for him.
That is, Dan, but he will see the ball more and more as the game goes on.
Third down, one man back. Williams loses one on the play, and that will bring up fourth down.
John Henderson was a one-man wrecking crew back there. He powered into the backfield and made the tackle.
Peter, that has to be tough to do. He used his weight to make the stop, and he did it against one of the most evasive players on the field.
You got to guess a direction in that situation, and he guessed right. That's instincts.
Fields the punt at the 16. Tackled at the 20.
David Allen didn't have much room to work with back there. The special team squad made sure he couldn't respond to that really nice punt.
The Jaguars come out on offense and are well ahead. They have yet another shot to score and start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Taylor gains 3 yards, and that brings up second down. Second down from the on. Greenwood tackles him behind the line of scrimmage.
Moreland Greenwood was a one-man wrecking crew back there. He powered into the backfield and made the tackle.
That's his second tackle so far. Leftwich zips it to the left sideline, and this one is incomplete.
Jimmy Smith dropped the ball so fast there, you'd think it bit him on the thumb or something.
That's two drops by one of the more sure-handed receivers in the game.
Wow, it's not often you see him out of sync like this.
Hansen lines up to punt after the three and out. Takes the snap and pummels this one deep. Fields the deep punt at the 27. Stopped at the 29.
Terrence Wilkins got pinned deep by a beauty of a kick there, and by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Dolphins can climb back into it with a score before half here. Down. They will start this drive at their own 29-yard line. Williams gains 3 yards, and that brings up second down.
That's the way to work them. Watch the pass. Here it comes. Watch the throw. Watch the throw. Double pass. Down.
Okay, fellas, we went over this all week in practice. Now we're going to get it this time. Now we're going to go just like it is. We're going to execute, okay. We're going to stay strong, and we're going to get to the spots we need to. Okay, fellas?
Ricky Williams just hasn't gotten into a groove and isn't finding running room anywhere. This has been tough, and he struggled to get 11 yards on 7 carries.
Can we get somebody in here that's going to challenge me, please?
Feely throws a bullet and it's off, incomplete.
David Boston had that ball in his hands on that play, and then he just dropped it.
That will bring up fourth down, and what a disappointment. That would have given them the first.
You got to make those plays when they come your way.
Don't let him kick it, D.
Turt lines up for the punt. Turt gets the snap and punts it away. Allen catches it at the 32. Brought down at the 33.
David Allen got swarmed by the kicking team before he got very far. That nice punt pretty much goes unanswered.
The Jaguars come out on the field and they're looking to extend their lead before halftime. They'll start at their 33-yard line. Williams goes in motion. Clock will continue to run. Second down, three wideouts in the game. Smith catches the... The Jaguars take their first timeout. Jaguars will take a timeout. That's their second. Second down with the tight end right. Williams hauls it in right side and is well past the markers for a first down.
Let's go, baby. Don't let him get a step on you.
Down.
Taylor has to carry on first down and picks up a couple. Second down, two wideouts on the field. Whips him down. The Jaguars take a timeout. That's their final one.
This is the series here, baby. We got to stop him.
Leftwich fires this one. It's intercepted. Tackled at the 28.
Dan, that was a beauty of an interception. Perfect read and jump on the ball.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
The Dolphins are going to try and capitalize on the interception. They'll start this drive at their own 28-yard line. Favors makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Greg Favors came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Thompson goes in motion. Feely lops this one out to the left, and it's complete at the 41. The Dolphins take their first timeout. First down, two receivers to the left. Tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Rasheen Mathis came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Feel the pressure, Chambers.
Feely zips it to the left sideline and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Dwayne Washington came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
That is their fourth batted ball. Tell you, we've seen a number of good defensive plays from this squad.
We sure have. We'll see if they can keep it up, though.
We almost got him, baby.
Third down and five wide receivers take the field. Makes a play on this one and forces the incompletion. Fourth down coming up.
Donovan Darius came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Well, the knee holds tight on third and long and forces an incompletion. That was a good call by the defensive coordinator.
Oh, it sure was. Perfect D for that situation.
And it will bring up fourth down. Fourth down, 10 yards to go. Mare launches the 52-yard attempt and it's through the uprights.
Orlando Mare really gets the whole ball here, and he needed it. Watch. That's a powerful kick for 3 points, my friend. When he needs to, he can boot that thing.
The field goal puts them a little closer to tying things up.
Yeah, and that's a positive note their coach can point to when he tries to pump up his team at halftime.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Mare kicks this one away. Allen fields it all the way back at the one. Finally dropped at the 33.
David Allen spotted a huge opportunity in the defense and just ran with it, logging some huge yardage for his team.
The Jaguars offense takes the field with the clock at 8. Taylor will get stopped at the line and that'll do it for the first half of this one. The Jaguars are out in front 10-3. And now let's send you to Chris Berman in our studios in Bristol for the ESPN halftime report. Boomer? The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Scobie kicks it, and the second half has now started. Welcome to the second half kickoff at the 6. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. Not a lot of efficiency there, and when they do score, you can see that it's the field goal variety. They need to punch it in if they want a shot.
Let's go down to Susie Kolber, who has an update for us. Susie?
Thank you, Dan. Head coach Dave Wannstedt came over at the end of the first half and simply said, too many first downs. It's still a close game, but if they're going to win this one, they've got to start to get some quick stops and leave their offense in good position to score. We'll see if they can figure it out in the third quarter. Back to you.
Susie, thank you. Williams gets the handoff and will lose about a yard here.
Marcus Stroud was a one-man wrecking crew back there. He powered into the backfield and made the tackle.
And I'll tell you, Peter, he made a great tackle there. He brought down one of the more elusive backs.
You're absolutely right, Dan. But if there's one guy on this defense that can stick with the ball and make the play, it was him.
Williams will get stopped at the line, and that will bring up third down.
Block me, please!
Feely throws a bullet and the reception's made at the 38. Hunted down at the 39. First down.
A.J. Feely goes right past the coverage and into his receiver's hand. Nice throw.
Third and long, and they get the big play to convert. What do you think of that, Peter?
I love it. That's what football is all about, making the big plays when you need to, and you can't coach that.
Single
Williams takes it across the line of scrimmage and picks up a couple. It looks like, we've had an injury down on the field. As soon as we hear anything, we'll be sure to pass the information along to you. Second down, one man back. Williams picks up six on the play, and that brings up third down.
Wide on that play, got the first and then slipped out of bounds. Great job.
Feely zings it to the right side and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Rasheen Mathis knocked that pass down, and he made sure the only one to touch the football was him.
They have really gotten after the ball as a team today. That is their fifth batted ball.
Nice, aggressive D.
Second down, tight end to the left. Williams gets the call on second down. The ball's loose. Tackled at the 48. Cling to it.
Mike Peterson delivers a punishing blow to the ball carrier there. And he gives up the football for the fumble. Great hard-nosed defensive play.
Peter, there are many ways you can start a drive, but a turnover is not one of them.
No, definitely not. That was a big-time play.
The Jaguars want to capitalize on the fumble and will start this drive at the 48-yard line. Williams goes in motion. Throws a heater right sideline and it's intercepted.
I'm coming.
And this is a nice interception. Check his position out to make the grab.
Got it. Well, that's their second interception of the game, and stingy is appearing to be the motto for their defense.
Yeah, either that or give me the ball.
The Dolphins' offense takes the field, and their running game has yet to get on track. We'll see if it happens here as they start at their 48-yard line. Mitchell tips it away on the coverage, incomplete. Grant was shaken up earlier, and I hear Susie Culber has a report for us. Susie?
Thanks, Dan. Well, after talking with team doctors, it appears that he's got a bruised calf muscle. They're icing it a bit right now, but it looks like he should be ready to come back in soon. Dan?
Thanks, Susie. Second down, three wideouts in the game. Feely gets all of his own, and it's caught at the 31.
A.J. Feely threw the pass into double coverage, but gets his man perfectly. Hey, that was one accurate throw.
A beautiful pickup, Peter. Everyone on the offense is happy about that play.
Definitely. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
And it will be a first down. Williams catches it in the flat and is at the 25. Runs out at the 21.
Ricky Williams got wide open and made the easy grab. Great job to take advantage of the D's confusion.
A nice run after the catch, and that's what they expect from him.
Heck, that's his job description. You won't see him running a post route, but you will see him make plays off those shorter catches.
McMichael goes in motion. Williams picks up a yard on the play, and that will bring up third down. Third down with the tight end right. Mitchell tips it away on the coverage, incomplete. That will bring up fourth down.
Anthony Mitchell came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate?
Field goal, fellas.
Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. Mare kicks from 38 yards out, and it's up through the goal post. Good.
Yeah, good job, man. Yeah.
Orlando Mare sends it whizzing between the goal post for a field goal straight down the pike.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Mare kicks it off. Allen fields the kickoff at the one. Tackled at the 25. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. How they turned the ball over leaps out at me, and you have to think that that could come back to haunt them. Turnovers are the most telling stat in the NFL. David Allen got a very respectable return off that nice kickoff there, Dan.
The Jaguars were intercepted last time out. We'll see what happens here. We'll start at their own 25-yard line. Leftwich throws a heater. And it's caught at the 31. And he stopped right there.
Jimmy Smith had two guys on him on that play, but still managed to make the catch.
Peter, yet another grab here in the third, and he's been working hard the whole game.
It's all about consistency, and he's been that today. What a player. Real time.
Smith gets a piece of this one, but that's all incomplete.
Jimmy Smith got a hand in there, but only enough to tip it away. Frustrating.
That would have gotten the first, but it's incomplete, and it will be third down. Leftwich zings it to the right side, and it's incomplete.
You ain't getting nothing past me, nothing past me, nope, nothing.
Hansen lines up to punt after the three and out. Hansen takes the long snap and pummels this one deep. Fields the deep punt at the 21. Dragged down at the 25.
Terrence Wilkins got pinned deep by a beauty of a kick there, and by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Dolphins' offense take the field, and other than a big play here and there, they have had problems. They are looking for an answer as they start at their own 25-yard line. Feely just rifles this one, and this one is incomplete.
Feel the pressure, Chambers.
Shotgun! Shotgun! Just do this one! Just do this one! Down! Set!
Black! Bulldoze bulldozes right of center and maybe picks up one on the play.
Ricky Williams powered forward with the football thanks to some initial blocking. Problem was they couldn't keep that push going for very long.
Well, not much of a gain there, and they will face third down.
Third and long, too, Dan. Big play coming up.
Third down on the backfield. Feely zings it to the right side, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Day,
it'll be fourth
day,
down.
You ain't get nothing.
Jerron Bolden came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
A nice defensive play will give him his second batted ball of the game.
Yeah, great read there.
Better hope I don't get my fingertips
Turf
on that ball.
Turf lines up for the punt. Turf gets the ball and punts it away. Allen feeds the punt at the 34. Brought down at the 39.
David Allen didn't have much room to work with back there. The special team squad made sure he couldn't respond to that really nice punt.
The Jaguars have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive as they start at their 39-yard line. Leftwich zips it to the left sideline, and it's caught at the 47. Eventually pushed out of bounds at the 36. It will be first down. First down, both wideouts to the right. They couldn't connect on this one. Incomplete.
Sammy Knight was able to force the incompletion back there. He stuck very close on that seam.
Potential for some nice yards, but the defense plays it tough. That will bring up second down. The reception is made past the markers for a first down.
Hey, I like those stats. Great receiving yards.
Taylor carries it for the 12th time and gains about 3 yards. And that'll do it for the third quarter. The Jaguars are out in front 10-6. Second down, two wideouts on the field. Picks up one on the play.
Fred Taylor used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not a lot of room on that play. It will be third down. Smith didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Jimmy Smith positioned himself on the outside back there, but the ball didn't position itself in his hands. No catch.
Peter, in third down situations, they have not been successful at all with the pass. This play was more proof.
Boy, third is such a crucial down, Dan. And when you don't convert, it really hurts.
Scobie kicks from 36 yards out, and he misses this one to the right.
Josh Scobie should be making these in his sleep, and yet, he finds a way to miss. Boy, that'll deliver a pile driver to your morale.
The Dolphins' offense is now on the field, and except for a few big plays, they really can't be happy with their passing game up to this point. We'll see what they call on this drive as they start at their own 26-yard line. Brackens blasts him back at the 24-yard line.
Let's go.
Ricky Williams has been searching for a rhythm out there, Dan, and he's coming up short. It seems like his timing is way off. He's working hard, but only has 17 yards on 15 carries.
You couldn't see me coming, Ricky?
Chambers goes in motion. Feely throws a beauty to the right side, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
David Boston bobbles the ball here and almost loses it, but he ends up with a great catch by using sheer determination. That's what you call staying with the ball. Oh, he got both hands on it and was able to bring it in. Great effort.
And I'll tell you what, he made that precision route look easy.
Too easy, almost. I'll tell you what, Dan, the D couldn't even hang with him there.
Williams chews up 9 yards, and that will bring up second down.
Ricky Williams sticks close to his blockers here. And it pays off.
Peter, what a nice pickup to get them into a second and short situation.
Yeah, great play, and now they have a bunch of options on what to try next.
Watch out for a run. Watch out
second
for
down,
run.
Two they tight ends run. In they the game. For his 17th carry and picks up the first down.
Yeah, baby, that's it. That's it.
Watch the pass. Watch the pass. Leopard, Leopard. Good, good, good. Down. Set.
Williams for a third time in a row and will lose about a yard here.
Tony Brackens targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Another tackle, and he's starting to fill up the stat book.
He is dominating, Dan. So far, he's got 5 tackles.
Feely rifles it out left side, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
A.J. Feely has had a number of pass attempts. We've seen that his guys are out there running their routes and trying to make plays. He would like to do a little bit more, however. So far, he's got 116 yards and no touchdowns.
Keep my field goal range.
Third down, and this is the 7th play of the drive. Bolden makes a play on this and forces the incompletion. It'll be 4th down.
Jerron Bolden got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
That's his 3rd batted ball, and he is doing his part, that is for sure.
Nice to see aggressive D like that, Dan.
Turk gets ready to punt this away. Turk gets the snap and punts it away. Allen fields it at the 16. Stopped at the 22.
David Allen fielded the ball, and although he was dropped pretty quickly, that terrible kick gives him some good field position.
The Jaguars offense takes the field with time winding down. They'll start at their own 22-yard line. Smith goes in motion. Chester tackles him behind the line of scrimmage.
Larry Chester targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
That's his 2nd tackle so far. 2nd down, just a single receiver on the field.
Owale Ogunle goes in unblocked and nails him to the ground. The O-line should be embarrassed. Watch this. Oh, yeah, sacks don't get much easier than that.
That will be 2 losses in a row.
Great reads by the D on the last 2 plays, Dan.
Down. catches it over the middle, and they get the first on third and long.
Come on, Dolphins. Let's get a stop. Come on, baby.
Watch the counter. Watch the counter. Counter.
Williams goes in motion. Taylor gets the call on first down and slowly gets back to the line of scrimmage. Second down with two tight ends to the right. Got the carry on second. The Dolphins take their first timeout. Third down. The clock is stopped at 1:54. Wilford goes in motion. Taylor gets the call on third down. The Dolphins will take a timeout. That's their second.
Yeah,
Hanson gets ready to punt this away. Takes the snap and punts it away. Wilkins fields the punt at the 17. Stopped at the 30.
Terrence Wilkins racked up a few yards on the run back there, whittling down the size of the punt a little bit.
The Dolphins start this drive of the game from well in their own territory, and the clock at 1:42. Feely throws this on a rope, and they can't connect. Incomplete.
David Boston ran a short out pattern on that last play, but he couldn't make the connection. Incomplete pass.
Those mid-range passes are not working out for them so far. Peter, what's different in that range?
Well, the coverage and their reaction time. The D is beating them to the punch right here.
Second down and five wide receivers take the field. Bolden tips it away on the coverage. Incomplete.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
Jerron Bolden came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
He records yet another batted ball. And I'll tell you, he's really playing well out there.
Yeah, he's been after the ball from the beginning of the game. Real aggressive play.
Third down. The clock is stopped at 1:35. Feely throws a high, long one. The Dolphins take a timeout. That's their final one. First down from the I.
Rhino, Rhino. Weak back, weak back.
No dice, and it falls incomplete.
Jerron Bolden shadowed the slant route back there and kept the receiver from making the catch. Incomplete pass.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Feely passes a high, long one, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Rasheen Mathis came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate it?
Third down and four wideouts in the game. Grant makes a play on this and forces the incompletion. That will bring up fourth down.
Deion Grant came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Well, the knee holds tight on third and long and forces an incompletion. That was a good call by the defensive coordinator.
Oh, it sure was. Perfect D for that situation.
And it will bring up fourth down. Feely throws a heater right sideline and it's intercepted. No one in front of him. And touchdown.
Chris Thompson picks off the ball, and he's going all the way. Nobody can stop him. Man, I hope his mom's got the VCR going.
That touchdown will stretch the lead, Peter, and it looks like they will walk away the winner here.
Well, it looks that way, Dan, but it's not over until it reads 00 up there.
The extra point, and it's good. There's the signal, and we're ready. Scobie kicks it off. Wilkins catches it back at the 10. Jukes back down at the 29.
Terrence Wilkins got waylaid by the defense before he was able to put Munch on the run back.
The Dolphins start this drive of the game from well in their own territory, and the clock at 103. No good, incomplete.
A.J. Feely has had difficulties, to say the least, and now he's second-guessing everything he's thrown. Terrible day. So far, he's struggled to get 136 yards and one interception.
Second down. The clock is stopped at 1 minute. Feely zips it to the left sideline, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
David Boston didn't have anybody on him, and yet he couldn't make the...
First down! See that? You see how I kept my feet in?
Yeah,
the drag, too. I had the drag. I had the drag. You see that?
Dan, when we check out the replay here, we should be able to see if the catch was made prior to going out of bounds.
He likes the call, and you sort of have a feeling that he knew it all along.
Woo!
All right, good job. Here, bring it together. Bring it together. Bring it together. You know exactly what you want to do. Go do it. Come on.
Third down, one man back.
Razor, down! Stay back, stay back!
Feely dumps it out left, and it's off, incomplete.
Rasheen Mathis had superb coverage on that play. No wonder it was incomplete.
It seemed like the defense read that one from the beginning, and they forced the incompletion with relative ease.
Beautiful call by the D coordinator.
It'll be fourth down.
You ain't getting nothing on four. I see two. Down.
Boston makes the catch in the flat, and he's short of the markers. They will forfeit the ball on down.
David Boston thinks he can make it on the outside, but he is mistaken. He goes out of bounds short of the marker. Let's watch. And now they lose possession.
not a good play.
Peter, that seemed like an odd situation to go for it on fourth down. What do you think?
Well, it was very gutsy, but maybe they should have used their heads and not their digestive system on that one.
How? How's that?
You know, guts.
Gutsy.
Gutsy. Digestive.
Got it. All right.
Fred, move the chains backwards.
Rhino! Down! Check! Blue 36! Blue 36!
That will do it for tonight's game. The Jaguars come out on top 17-6. For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.
That was a tough one for you, man.
We had him. Okay. Next time.